abstain from any form of evil. May the God of peace himself sanctify you entirely, and may your spirit and soul and body be kept sound and blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Thanks be to God.
We come to the signing of the Freedom Road Association. I'd like to invite the Bulgarian Orthodox Lord Gladden to address us. I'd also like to say that Roy was particularly keen that this signing of the Freedom Road had happened during his tenure as Lord Mayor. And with just over a fortnight left, we managed to achieve that. But there is a long connection between Roy and the association, and also Roy, of course, the Armed Forces Champion for the Council and for Liverpool for some years now. And I know that this will be one of the final moments in his final activities as the Armed Forces Champion. And I think we should also thank Roy for all that he has done for the Armed Forces in this country.
Lord Lieutenant, High Sheriff, Reverend Sir, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. It gives me great pleasure as Lord Mayor and Liverpool City Council's Armed Forces Champion to admit the Liverpool Scottish Regimental Association to the Freedom Role of Associations and Institutions, including the freedom right of entry to the City of Liverpool. Today, the City of Liverpool acknowledges the Association's outstanding contribution to our local community. The Liverpool Scottish Regimental Association was formed in 1930 to provide support to those who had served in the First World War by the way of social activities and welfare. The latter objective was to honour the work of the regiment's wartime medical officer, Captain Noel Shabazz, VC and Bar, MC. This benevolent role has been a constant throughout the existence of the association, with support being provided to veterans from Liverpool and the wider Merseyside area, and continues to the present day in conjunction with other military charities. The association also provides a means for the camaraderie which soldiers experience during their service for their country and continues today into civilian life. As the City Council's Armed Forces Champion, it has been my pleasure for a number of years and privilege to have worked with the members of, and the families of the Liverpool Scottish Regiment. I have, on several occasions, been welcomed by the regiment to the regimental dinner. But the least said about those evenings are better, so I'll just continue with my speech. The Lady Mayoress and I were also invited to attend the unveiling of the Liverpool Scottish Memorial in 2022 in the Arboretum. The sounds of those pipes and drums from the regimental band are one of the major highlights of my mayoral year, and it'll be a day I will never forget. The military has always had close links with the City of Liverpool. I always feel privileged to welcome the men and women who make up our armed forces, and for those who have proudly served their country. Today, these close links are evident, and it is an opportunity for me, on behalf of the city, but more importantly, the people of our city, to express our gratitude to all those who served, who have served, and with such high levels of dedication, commitment and professionalism as always shown by the Liverpool Scottish. Throughout the Liverpool Scottish Regiment's distinguished history, the links with the city and surrounding borders are clearly identifiable by the number of recruits who have joined the regiment over its many years. The commitment and support by those who have served and their families is exemplary. It requires very special people to be able to take on such a role as yours, and I speak on behalf of everyone in the city and thanking you for doing your duty. I hope that you all feel immensely proud of yourselves and will fondly remember today's event for a long time to come, as I will. Thank you and congratulations. The honour is well deserved. Family, and in personal capacity, James Axon and his comrades have tirelessly supported me throughout my time as Armed Forces Champion, and specifically in the last 12 months in my mayoral year. It is therefore my great pleasure to present Piper Major James Axon with the new banner for his bagpipe, and the city's thanks go to him and his comrades for all you have done. Thank you very much.
We decided, waiting with James over these years, that the old banner started to get a bit mucky. No matter how often James brings it up, we hope that you'll accept this with our profound thanks for everything that you and your colleagues have done throughout the years, both for myself and the city. Thank you, James.
Thank you.
Just for clarity, what we're doing now is signing the Freedom of Association. Both myself and Michelle.
If anyone would like to take photographs, please feel free to do so. Major Boardman. Just close in for the photographs, please.
Thank you.
Lieutenant, High Sheriff, Reverend Sir, sorry, Reverend Sir. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to express on behalf of all the members of the Liverpool Scottish Regimental Association our grateful thanks to the Lord Mayor and to the members of the Liverpool City Council for bestowing this high honour on our association. The Liverpool Scottish, when designated as the 10th Battalion of the King's Liverpool Regiment, have the freedom of the city conferred upon them in 1931 as a battalion of that regiment. When the Liverpool Scottish were rebadged as the 1st Battalion, Liverpool Scottish Queen's Own Cavalry Highlanders in 1937, the City Council acknowledged the change by a resolution of the Council. In both guises, the regiment exercised on a number of occasions the right to march through the city of Liverpool with bayonets fixed, flags flying, and drums beating. We today have had the opportunity to do the same, albeit without bayonets fixed. Exchange flags provides a link to both predecessor battalions that I have mentioned, as the 10th Battalion paraded on exchange flags in 1914, just before the First World War, and we again, as an association, paraded on exchange flags in 2009, when the colours of the 1st Battalion, Liverpool Scottish Queen's Own Cavalry Highlanders, were laid up in Liverpool Town Hall. The Liverpool Scottish Regimental Association was formed in 1930 under the chairmanship of Lieutenant Colonel Donald Farmer, VC, and we endeavour to this day, over 90 years later, to hold to the five objects that the association set out for itself all those years ago. The principal objects were to support the members in whatever way was deemed necessary and to maintain the esprit de corps of the regiment, which has been forged and maintained in both peace and war. I believe the fact that we do endeavour to hold to these initial objects makes the grant of the honour of admission to the Freedom Roll of Associations and Institutions of the City of Liverpool so gratifying to myself and to my fellow members. I thank you.
So let us pray. Holy God, a protector, and for all who serve in the armed forces today. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Bring healing and wholeness to people and nations. Let your mercy rule all that we do. Be with all who defend your truth and your peace. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Be with all medics and chaplains and all who support and suffering. Give them wisdom and skill, sympathy and patience. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Be with those in need, with members of the association facing sickness. Sustain the anxious and fearful. Let your mercy be shown to all, and your power to heal and save. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Receive those fallen in battle and all the innocents who have died. Surround their loved ones with compassion and give them a patient faith. Lord, in your mercy.
The Liverpool Scottish Connect. God, the Father of our Lord, Jesus Christ, of whom the whole family in heaven and earth is named, give thy spirit of the Liverpool Scottish that, as our fathers have borne themselves as one against many enemies, so may we ever remain one family in thee. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. And let us pray with confidence, as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Amen. among you and remain